Stephanie Primeaux grew up a Navy brat in California and Rhode Island. With a father, brother, husband, and other relatives in the Navy, you might say the Navy is almost a family business.
I've always been surrounded by anything Navy affiliated.
A student, a mother, and a Navy veteran, Stephanie is no stranger to hard work. That hard work recently paid off for the mechanical engineering student. She's the recipient of a $5,000 SoldierStrong scholarship awarded to a female veteran at ODU with the highest GPA in a STEM-related discipline.
All this hard work and all the late nights and the studying and the not so great scores on exams are all worth it because at the end of the day, like, I'm gonna get my degree.
From early on, Stephanie learned the value of family. With a husband who is also a student with a full-time job, she relies on the support she gets from that family.
My mom and my dad help out a lot. If I have to stay here late, they'll go pick up my daughter, and my husband's also in school too, so with both of us managing school, he has a full-time job, I have my part-time job, and our daughter, it really helps to have family around, and my dad always taught us to put family first.
Stephanie also believes strongly that everyone should consider serving their country.
Not just because I think that it should be like a duty to your country, but you just get to meet different people, you get to experience different things.
Stephanie didn't just join the Navy to serve her country. She took on one of the most difficult and competitive jobs in the U.S. Navy, nuclear electrician.
I didn't want to do a regular job. I wanted to do something challenging, so he suggested being a nuke electrician. I knew that it was the hardest school that the Navy had to offer, and I also know that they had really good advancement rates. And once you got out, a lot of colleges gave you credits towards a degree in a STEM program.
The job of a Navy nuclear electrician requires the highest level of math and science skills in all of the military, and for good reason. These men and women are solely responsible for operating a nuclear reactor for submarine and aircraft carrier power and propulsion.
I never thought that I could do engineering. I was always good at math and science, but it was never something that I saw myself in. And after my time in the Navy, I liked what I did. I liked working on machinery, and I liked the schooling that I went through, so I thought that I could do it at ODU.
After 6 years of service, Stephanie returned to ODU with more confidence and an even greater determination to use the skills and values she learned in the Navy, even though the idea of being a career engineer wasn't always in the cards for her.
I think that ODU definitely has a good relationship with other agencies, and having that on my resume, going for a bachelor's in mechanical engineering, holds up high with other companies, so I think that helps coming from ODU. I think that you get like a step up.
Being a woman in a male-dominated field doesn't seem to intimidate Stephanie.
Sometimes I think it does benefit me to be a woman because then people feel maybe they have to give me a chance, and then once they do, then they realize that, oh, well, maybe we should have given her a chance regardless if she was a woman or not.
As for advice for other aspiring female engineers?
The best advice that I can have to other female engineers is just to keep trying. Don't be discouraged. Don't try to overcompensate. Just do the best you can and seek help when needed, because professors and even your peers are willing to help you.
For the Batten College of Engineering and Technology, this is Keith Pierce reporting.